We're boarding the plane to Madrid. How do you feel? You're so funny. I'm on the plane now, and the seats beside me are empty on both sides. Let me show you. There's no one, so this is gonna be fun. We were supposed to leave at 4:55. Been walking down up and down the high street, and we came to a cemetery, and it's very interesting. I don't know what we're doing now. I think we're trying to kill time before we eat dinner, so stay tuned. Thank you. us. Enter the door. Closet thing. Shelves. Bathroom. Bed. Cot. Window. TV. Desk. Me! Okay, hey guys. So right now I am in my hotel room. I don't know if you can hear wind because the window is open right behind my camera and the TV is on. However, I wanted to tell you guys kind of about today, what we did, because it's been a really freaking long day. I'm combining day one and two together, so like travel day and then because we were still traveling today. So our first flight was from Charlotte to Madrid, and it was a mess because it was storming in Charlotte when we left, so we had a 50-minute delay. And then when the delay was over, we were finally able to go. Well, our layover in Madrid was only scheduled for an hour and 45 minutes. So we were supposed to land at 7 a.m. and board at 8:45. Well, we didn't get to Madrid until like 7:50. And so we got off the plane and we were rushing. So we got off the plane and we went and we were trying to figure out where we were supposed to go, so they sent us to passport control, and then passport control sent us back to like the Iberian Airlines like desk for us to get our boarding passes fixed, and then they sent us to a security checkpoint, and then to go through that security, the like I wasn't sure if they had any like different rules than American airports do as far as going through security. Like I know what I gotta do, like take off my shoes and like take my liquids out of my bag and take my laptop out and stuff, but they needed all electronics out and they needed like all of our bags separate and stuff and like stuff like that. And I had a water bottle that was full of water, but because I had literally come from a plane in an airport to another airport, it was okay that I had it. This was like taking forever, and so I make all my stuff go through the security thing, and then I walk through and like the thing doesn't go off or anything. So then I'm going to get my bags and she's like, is this yours? And I was like, yeah. And this is like in Spain, so it's very broken English, it's hard to understand. So I take my stuff and I go put it back through the checkpoint afterwards, and they checked my water bottle. They like tested it to make sure that there was nothing in it that like could harm someone. It was just water. And then there was also whenever I walked through, it went off for some reason, but it didn't go off the first time. Like I had glasses on, and then I also had my like rings and necklace on, but like that kind of stuff doesn't normally make it go off. So then they took like these strips and like did them on both palms, and then it's like blurry on my lens, sorry. They did it on both sides of my hands, and then they like ran it through, and then they did my hips, which is really weird, and I felt super violated because I didn't want them touching me, but whatever. So we went through to that, and then we like basically sprinted to our gate because there were two flights leaving out of Madrid to Birmingham at 8:45. So we sprinted to the gate and we got there, and the lady was like, hurry, there's no time, hurry up, come on faster. So we were going, and this is when it gets real, okay? So then she tries to scan our boarding passes. Mine worked, but the other three didn't, and she couldn't get them to go fast enough. What was that? So she told them to just go and she would get their boarding passes to them. And so we went, and like because we were late because of all the stuff with security and all that stuff took so long, the plane had already been shut and they had like put like a barricade up so that we couldn't like go, so we just like moved it so we could go past. And she was taking forever because the attendant was supposed to be behind us and we couldn't figure out what was taking so long. So I dropped my stuff and I ran up to the gate to see what was going on, and she was like, why did you go past this? There was a barrier here. Like, why did you go through this? Why would you do this? And like, she didn't tell us where to go. She was super vague. So then we run down some stairs, we get on a bus, and then she drives us like halfway around the world. So basically all over the Madrid airport to take us to our actual plane. And then we finally board the plane. We were the last people on the plane. They asked us why we were late when we first got on before I would board. It was a mess before they let us board. Last person on the plane.
So everyone was staring at us when we got on, and then whenever I went to go sit down, I sat in the wrong seat, so then I had to move, and oh my gosh, it was endless. So I did not have time to stop to get something to eat, to get something to drink, to pee in Madrid. But then we made it to Birmingham, and immigration and all that was easy, and we came back to the hotel, and then so yeah, that's all I have for today. So I'm going to end today's vlog here because I am so tired. I hope you like the vlog. I hope these are good for you, and I hope that you guys like this stuff. So yeah, I just told you the story of how almost got stranded in Spain because I really thought they were about to leave us. But guess what? I learned that the Lord is faithful because I got on that plane and I am here in Birmingham now. So I'm so excited for what this week is going to bring for us. And that's the end of the first and second days since they're kind of together, you know. So yeah, that's all I've got. Peace out. Good night.